Tonight, I will make a carbonara di mare, so the typical carbonara, but instead of bacon, I'm going to use seafood.
So for 100 grams of spaghetti, a bit of thyme, the usual suspect, salt, pepper, and olive oil, a bit of garlic, one clove, 2 egg yolk, 20 grams of parmesan, and the equivalent weight of the pasta in fish, equally split. So for 100 grams, I have 100 grams of fish, and I'm using swordfish, red snapper, and tuna. In a bowl, I put the 2 egg yolk with the parmesan, the thyme leaves, salt and pepper, and with a fork, you can gently mix it. You don't need to put too much air inside, so no need to be too vigorous. Kick off the pasta, and the moment you start the pasta, count 8 minutes, and then you will finish the last 2 in the pot. I let the garlic cook for a minute, make sure that the garlic doesn't burn, and then I toss the fish, and I quickly, at a very high fire, stir it. Half a glass of wine to perfume it. Make sure that the wine evaporates. Amazing smell. So once the wine evaporates, you take out the cubes of fish from the pan and you leave the sauce in there because we're gonna saute the pasta. We're gonna risottare the pasta inside the sauce. So now I'm gonna put the pasta in the sauce and let it cook for 2 minutes by stirring it vigorously, because now the pasta needs to release all its amid. I've added a cup of cooking water into the pan as well. Water into the cream of eggs. And then I need to quickly turn, otherwise the eggs will cook. Pasta is almost ready. As usual, I tried. Still a little bit more of cooking. Add the egg cream slowly. Spaghetti carbonara di mare, seafood carbonara. Looks good, it's quite wet. Maybe I should have dried a bit more, but looks good. Enjoy and buon appetit.